I guess you guys can't hear, but you should be able to hear me now. I'm not really gonna say anything during this run because I don't really know anything about it. So, if anybody wants to pop in here, they can. Let me know if you're hopping in here so I can turn on the desktop audio so you guys can hear yourself or so we can hear you, because I have it off right now so you can only hear me.
Felipe said earlier, anyone can talk over my run because I'm gonna be YouTube.
Okay, yeah, I wasn't sure. I know he said he didn't want to do commentary, I guess, so that's fine.
But, I don't really know much about the game, though.
This is a pretty fresh game. Like, a lot of people, when they run Kirby Superstar, don't do any percent, so I'm very happy to see someone doing any percent today. Mostly, you use the jet. The jet copy ability is really fast, and I think you use the bird as well, and you know, I'm not super familiar with the run, but it's definitely a fresh run, and I'm really excited to see it here, over the more common 100% that you would normally see people doing. For whatever reason, people are more likely to run to the Superstar.
I'll be right back.
Alright.
Rolling in.
Hi, Overfiend.
Hi, Overfiend.
Hi. Hi, Hiso. Hi, Bix.
So, yeah, as you can see, the jet is pretty fucking fast.
Jets usually are.
Yeah. Oh, is RPG here? Yeah. And the music is good enough to where you kind of don't want people talking over it.
Super loud on Discord to me, at least.
I am probably more quiet than usual because I'm on my left.
stab at you. Never. I've already got my game for the 12-hour challenge.
So what's your favorite copy ability in Kirby Superstar? Or do you guys know anything about the game at all?
I don't know too much. The only one I played was on a game.
That one's pretty... Depending which one is, probably really old.
Yeah.
I watched Countdown do attempts. And Sweetie T do attempts, but that was a long time ago.
My favorite ability is the rock.
Do they still have the umbrella? Where, like, he gets the umbrella and uses the umbrella?
I don't remember, honestly. I haven't played this game in a long time. I don't remember if you can use the umbrella in this game. You probably can. But it wouldn't be very useful in the speedrun.
I mean, yeah, cool. I like the jet because it goes fast.
Well, I like the rock and it's slow as fuck. It doesn't move.
You just turn into a rock.
Yeah. There's like a 5% chance you turn into a statue or something.
Yeah, the umbrella, it's called the parasol. It's in this game, I'm pretty sure.
So what you just did here was choosing two copy abilities at once, and it gives you a slot. And in the slot has all the abilities, and you can win the lottery and get the jet again. But I'm not too sure I would want to say that it's pretty easy to get whatever you want out of that.
I think it's like, I don't know if it's frame perfect, I want to say it's like a 3-frame window or something to time it. It's some small window to actually time the input for confirming one.
This game's soundtrack is really nice.
Yeah, it is. I agree. So when you're underwater, you cannot use your ability. Most abilities cannot be used underwater. There are a few that can. At least one that I can think of right now.
That's usually what any percent means.
Oh god, I need a piss.
Roll it up.
I don't think there's anything you really can do, like skipping stories. Main menu, you pick what story you're gonna do, and you start out with some really easy ones, and then you unlock more as it goes on.
Okay.
Morning.
Going back.
This this song is the best.
Every song in this game is the best.
Yeah, but this one's objectively amazing.
Well, I agree.
Maybe I need to stop with Volker.
Nah, two more.
Just like an anime.
Yes. Overfiend would know if he's a huge weak.
I tried looking up what the difference between any percent and 100% is, just to make sure I wasn't wrong. All I know is that in Hundo, you collect all the treasures. There's a lot of treasures throughout the game, and you know you have them all when your gold points say like 999999 or whatever. Something like that.
I'm not sure if you do the boss rush at any percent.
But yeah, I didn't see an explanation on speedrun.com on their page of what the difference is, so...
I wouldn't think you do the boss rush. I really don't know.
Yeah, I would assume not with 40 minutes, but...
Well, the boss rush is pretty fast. But it's at the end of Hundo. After the credits?
Yeah, there's credits and then it's like...
the credits roll. The timer goes on while the credits go on, and then you play the boss rush. So, like, I really am gonna say that you don't do the boss rush, and the game time ends at the credits. Which would mean that you do Milky Way missions. We're currently in Revenge of Meta Knight. Or no. Is that what it's called? Isn't that a Wii game or some shit? I don't know. I can't keep up with the new game name, so forgive me. But this particular story is the Meta Knight story. And then next should be the Great Cave Offensive, or... Man, I'm really trying hard to remember the names called.
The Great Cave Offensive.
And that will be... That will go much faster than with Hundo. Because, you have to spend a lot of time collecting shit. If this were Hundo.
What's the time difference between the two?
It's like a half hour.
Oh.
A little more. But yeah, 3.5 hours. Which I guess is just entirely from treasure collecting and the boss rush after credits.
And watching credits, yeah.
Yeah. That too.
So Felipe is tearing the shit out of this game. Looks like he's having a good run for me.
As far as we can tell, he's having an awesome run.
Whoa.
Oh man, we jinxed him.
Whoa.
Or did we? Now this ability is pretty OP. You can charge up and make plasma shots that destroy any enemy. Anything you want.
Yeah, I don't know if you explained it, if anybody has, but like the certain type of plasma you shoot out, I think, is dependent on like how fast you mash the D-pad as you're charging or something like that before you release. So
yeah, you could shoot out like a Hadouken or like an arrow-looking thing.
So like right here, he's like spamming the D-pad to get out like the proper blast at this turret.
Yeah, it's pretty technical. It's really cool the way this game works, like every ability. If you press the start menu, they all are pretty technical and have their own unique inputs. We have an auto-scroller, it seems. Can really see how OP this ability is.
Yeah, no use. So he tosses a sword and then he swallows plasma after making it a companion so that he can have plasma instead of sword.
That is a feature in this game. You can turn your copy ability into a NPC. Or it can be a playable character if you have your two controllers in. It's pretty useful if you want to put aside your ability to use for later.
Now we're rolling out away from the exploding ship.
And this psycho. So there is a pretty long cutscene after that he skipped by resetting, I believe. I'm not sure because he went right into the menu of the game select right away, so I'm not sure if there's a fast way to reset.
Yeah, this one, like you see 0G there, like 100% you would collect every treasure, and I believe when you have every treasure, it would say like one less than a million, so like 6/9 or whatever, something like that. I guess that takes a really long time to do, getting every treasure.
Bird is a pretty cool ability. You go pretty fast when you're the bird. Not as fast as the jet, because you have to pause in between your whatever you want to, your dashes. But it's still pretty fast, and you can get it very early in the Great Cave. Yeah. now we have the jet.
Yeah, the bosses in this game look really cool. I like that one.
Same.
Like that whale and then the computer program simulation thing later.
It has some really nice levels, actually.
The chameleon's cool. I remember something about the chameleon, like, you could steal a unique ability from it. But the ability didn't really do anything. Like painted stuff. I don't really remember. It's been a long time.
Yeah, those bosses are yours.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure there's some RNG here.
Yeah, I think the choices and what attacks they use. And maybe length, like maybe how long it gives you to attack also, but I'm not too sure.
Riding those cards, but they're slow as shit. That you can kill it off screen. Very thoughtful of the developers, thank you. And that's the end of the Great Cave Offensive. It's way, way, way shorter than in Hunjo. Alright, we're in Milky Way now, and the gimmick with Milky Way is you don't have any abilities. You cannot use abilities until you find them. And then once you find the ability, it's in the menu and you can select it at any time.
Oh look, he found it.
was very fast to kill. Very nice.
I want my very own jet map.
Casually, that boss takes quite a while because he keeps rising up and you have to follow him. Also, I apologize if I'm giving any misinformation. I don't really remember this game that well, but I'm trying.
Yeah, same. I mean, right now I kind of wish, like, I wish I knew more about what he's doing, because from what I can tell, if you're watching like Countdown Speeds, he, like, Felipe is playing really well.
Yeah, he is playing. I can tell he's playing very well. Good movement. He didn't lose his ability or anything. Sorry, I seem to be having some lag. So, in the Milky Way, you just go from planet to planet. And then after you finish all the planets, the final boss will unlock.
Go from planet to planet, destroying everything in your path.
Yeah. Well, you have to fight one thing, and then you go to the final boss. Spoilers.
Thank you.
Rolling in.
Yo, Demons.
Rolling in.
Martin.
Rolling in.
So, the gimmick for this planet is seasons. Every time you enter a door, the season changes. And the boss is double this speed. But that wasn't challenging at all. Just kick his ass right away. So again, being underwater is really annoying. It's slow movement, but this is the underwater planet, so some of it you just have to be underwater.
Rolling back in.
Damn straight I did. That sounds like a good idea.
A beer is not liquor.
No, I've got some others. Yeah.
Kind of.
Needs to be louder.
What's for lunch?
Pizza.
Nice.
Yes. Ah. Oh. What was that place we got that mac and cheese and that fucking Subway place? It was the one in DC, like 2 years ago, 3 years ago, I don't know. Yeah. Like, me and Joe got mac and cheese, everyone else got sandwiches. Yeah.
I've never had mac and cheese.
What?
Yo, you need that shit and some hot sauce.
I don't really like cheese too much.
What?
No, it's told the devil would tempt me.
Felipe's run is very sexy. It's gonna be over to the last planet. Is gonna roll out to the final.
Rolling.
A few minutes. We'll give it like 5 minutes.
It better be done in 5 minutes.
I don't know, maybe a little bit less than 5 minutes.
Oh, it wasn't Pantera bread, was it?
Panera bread?
Panera bread.
Panera bread is pretty popular American shit. They have soup and like macaroni and coffee and shit.
Oh yeah. I don't think it was.
Keep thinking.
It was... All I remember is we got back and I said to Stray, and he turned around and went, oh, I didn't think they were still here anymore. I thought they'd all shut down. So I'm really confused.
I don't know what to tell you.
I got an idea. I'm gonna Google it.
Macaroni. Good macaroni. Google it and see what you get. Oh, dude, sap.
Some thoroughbred.
Yeah.
Is that what you said?
Yes.
That is what he said, yes. Alright, so this is a bit of an auto scroller, but as long as you get the fast cycle, you know, it's as fast as it possibly can be.
Breaker 1-9.
Whoa!
Yeah, the trick of this is, like, it's like you get to the last one and you damage it really low, and then you go backwards, and I don't know. I don't remember.
Good talk.
Thank you, everything.
I do know there's, like, an optimal but slightly difficult strat with this section, like the last section.
I could never do that. It does look difficult. I always took a 2-cycle.
It's like you leave one up so that when you go backwards, you can kill it faster. Yeah, that one. I guess. I never realized to say that one. It's gonna happen like 20 seconds later. Oh, I guess it's easier than I remember. No, he has to fight Marks.
There's a boss after this. Lucas, I'm gonna have to come over there very soon.
Whoa. Yeah, I assume it's the last hit of this guy, but then this guy freezes and dies. Right there. No. Yeah, I guess.
Thank you,
Obi. It's like 3809 or something.
That's really hot. Felipe's PB on speedrun.com is 37 minutes and 53 seconds.
Well, I'm glad he was playing as well as we thought he was.
Blew it out.
I've had my mic. You guys can hear me.
Good job.
Yeah, nice run. I said that earlier. Alright, so, I guess, Pixie, just fire up your stream whenever you're ready.
Alright, I'm gonna run over to my computer and I'll be right back in the call.
Oh, yeah!
It should be live.
Alright, next up is a clown game.
It's not a clown.
It's a clown.
Look at you, dingus.
What is it?
A clown?
A little boy.
Basically a clown.
Someone used to dress back in the day.
The fuck, that's how I dress now.
What's the estimate on this?
Yeah. I think 13.
1359. Oh, exactly. Okay. And it's called, what's the full name again? Noddy's.
Noddy and the Birthday Party. Hopefully my stream doesn't cut out.
We're about to have a Noddy birthday party. Hope you guys are ready.
Happy birthday, Noddy.
Is it any percent?
It's not even a percent, it's just easy.
Or do you want me to actually put easy?
Do whatever you want, right?
What's rolling in after this? Right?
It was Pantera Bread.
But
yeah, that doesn't sound as good.
Yeah, nice work, Felipe. Alright, let me fire up Vixie here. Sorry you didn't... you probably didn't even hear me the whole time, so...